Care to join me? Do you care to grab your Bible and come and join me and let's hit the streets? Let's just get out there and share the gospel of Jesus Christ and win some souls for the kingdom. What say you? Are you prepared to do that? When's the last time you had an experience like that? When's the last time you said, yeah, you know, let's just go out there, you know, and witness the love of Jesus Christ to a dying world? Well, this is what discipleship is all about. It's about sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's about sharing the good news. It's about sharing the good news to a dying generation or to a dying world. And Lord knows it is dying. But yet, not many people are willing to go out there and risk being rejected or risk being ridiculed or, you know, I can hear some people saying, that's just not my thing. But if you say that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, then this is what he expects from you. Let's go to Luke, the 9th chapter and the 23rd verse. He says here, and he said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. He said to them all, if. I guess Jesus understood that everybody that was with him or everybody that came to see him or to hear him would not necessarily follow him. And just as it was then, I say it is again today. I believe that everybody that go to church that profess to be a Christian are not willing to follow Jesus, are not willing to forsake all. And so the topic for this series is if. If. Are you among the if? You know, if Jesus says come, you know, and follow me, would you do it? If he was here today and, you know, doing the miracles and doing the healings and had such an awesome message like we do a lot of these televangelicals that are on TV now, would you go to Jesus? Would you be prepared to forsake all, to let go of everything just to follow him? And even though he is not here physically, he still requires this of us. Let's read it again from the New Living Translation. He says it like this. Then he said to the crowd, if any of you wants to be my follower, you must turn from your selfish ways, take up your cross daily, and follow me. And if is a conditional clause. It says if we were to substitute the word if, we would use something like in case that you want to follow me, this is what I expect of you. Or supposing that you become a follower of mine, this is what I expect of you. For granting that you become a follower, these are my expectations of you. And that's what the Bible is saying to us today. He wants us to deny self, take up our cross daily, and follow him. So let's look at the denial of self thing. And that's where most people don't even get up to the taking up the cross daily part, because they can't get beyond denying self. What does that mean to deny self? It means that it's not about me. It's not about what I want. It's not about what I think I deserve. It's not about what I think I should have. It's about Christ. It's about doing his will. It's about following him. But we, you know, take the gospel and we focus it on us as if God is here to do our good pleasure. God is here to serve us as opposed to us serving God. Pay attention to some of the messages, most of the messages, and, you know, I've been doing that for quite a while. And when you flick the TV or you go to, your various houses of worship, your messages are basically the same thing. You know, God wants you to be blessed. God wants to give you increase. God wants to, you know, it's your harvest time. This is your season. Plant your seed. And all this is, the message are click, 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 same, same, same. But I don't hear anybody saying, you know, no, if you want to follow Jesus, then deny yourself. You know, free yourself from the material things in the world. It doesn't mean that we don't have material things. It just means that that's not a priority. You know, my priority is not for me to get and to get more and to get even above that. All right? My priority is to do the will of God. My priority is to follow in the footsteps of Christ. My priority, and Jesus is letting them know, this is not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy to follow him, just like it's not easy to even give this message. Because it's not a popular one. This is not a popular gospel. Definitely not today. You know, how many churches are going to want to receive a message like that? They're not going to want to hear this. No, because what's in it for me? I don't hear the me part in here. But when Jesus said deny itself, that means there is no me part. There is no you. There is no me. It's all about him. It's about following him. You know, and then to take up our cross daily. As you know, that's going to be interesting. That's going to be challenging. That's going to be difficult. Why? Because it's not a popular gospel. No. And when you get out in the street, people are going to call you names. They're going to call you, put labels on holy rollers and Jesus freaks and all this other kind of stuff. And would you subject yourself to that type of ridicule? Because that's what will be required. You know, we got to share the good news to a sinful, in a sinful world. In our communities, people are not thinking about letting go of anything because they love their sin, period. But doesn't stop us from sharing it anyway. And this is what Jesus is saying to us. And if we go down to Luke, the 14th chapter, and the 27th verse, listen to this. He says, and if you do not carry your own cross and follow me, you cannot be my disciple. So, you can make a decision. He's not going to force you. But he's saying, if you do not take up your own cross, not his cross, you know, our own cross. I have a cross, you have a cross, and follow him. We cannot be a disciple. So if we are not doing that, then what are we? Because we won't be a disciple of Jesus Christ. Then what will that make us? Well, that just makes me a Christian. But you confessed him as your Lord. And if you confess him as your Lord, he becomes your master. You become the servant. And if you're not obedient, what does that make you? I think the word that they use is called a hypocrite. And the church is filled with people who profess Jesus Christ but do not follow him. And we're going to get more into that when I come back the next time. I'm Pastor Aminata. If God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you're sincere and that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says in Romans chapter 10 that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe with my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now, I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and I need God in my life. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God who went to the cross to wash away my sin. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, I want you to email us and let us know. Because right now, you're saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and pray that God would lead you to a Bible-believing church where you can continue to grow in grace. God bless you.